The polymerase chain reaction, in short, PCR, is a standard laboratory method applied in molecular biology for the amplification of specific segments of double-stranded DNA. PCR is based on the mechanisms of DNA replication, though it's performed in vitro. The underlying principle is quite simple. First, the double-stranded DNA, which serves as the template in the reaction, is separated by heat. Next, a DNA polymerase synthesizes a new daughter strand on each single strand in one direction. By repeating these reactions continuously, a defined segment of DNA, the target, is amplified exponentially. This and the high specificity of the reaction enable the amplification of target DNA segments from even very small amounts of template DNA. So, what are the detailed reaction steps in a PCR? At the start of the first cycle, the reaction mixture contains double-stranded template DNA, four different types of nucleotides, the building blocks of DNA, which are deoxyadenosine triphosphate, deoxyguanosine triphosphate, deoxycytidine triphosphate, and deoxythymidine triphosphate. A special heat-stable DNA polymerase, which still functions after heating to high temperatures to denature the DNA. Such thermostable polymerases originate from thermophilic bacteria. For example, TAC polymerase from the microorganism Thermus aquaticus. Finally, two different primers. These are short sequences of nucleotides that serve as sequence-specific starting points for DNA synthesis. DNA polymerases bind to the primers, using them to attach new nucleotides to form a new DNA strand. Each primer facilitates the amplification of the bound DNA in one direction, restricting the strand's length to the desired target on one side. The PCR now proceeds as follows. The temperature is increased to approximately 90 to 95 degrees Celsius to denature the DNA and separate the strands. Next, the temperature is decreased to 50 to 60 degrees Celsius for the primers to attach to the complementary DNA sequences. This process is called annealing. During the elongation step, the temperature is increased again to around 70 degrees Celsius, the optimal temperature for DNA polymerase activity. The enzyme attaches nucleotides to the primer's 3' end, extending the strand in this direction. Each attached nucleotide thereby serves as the attachment point for the next complementary nucleotide. In the first amplification cycle, two long DNA strands are obtained, which exceed the desired target on one side. The DNA fragment to be amplified is now present in two double strands and therefore duplicated. During the second cycle, the temperature is increased again to 90 to 95 degrees Celsius. The double-stranded DNA molecules in the reaction mixture denature. Next, the temperature is decreased to the annealing temperature again. The primers dock onto their specific DNA sequences. DNA polymerase then synthesizes the complementary DNA strands at approximately 70 degrees Celsius. After the second cycle, the DNA present in the reaction mixture has doubled once more. Now, there are already two DNA fragments corresponding in length to the target DNA segment. In the third cycle, the amount of DNA present doubles again by undergoing the process of denaturation, annealing, and elongation. With each subsequent PCR cycle, the number of DNA molecules of desired length increases rapidly. Correspondingly, the amount of variable length segments increases comparably slower and becomes negligible. After around 30 cycles, the target DNA sequence determined by the choice of primers is now amplified by a factor of 10 to the power of 6 to 10 to the power of 10. This factor depends on the amplification efficiency. The amplified DNA can now be analyzed. The DNA is therefore usually visualized using gel electrophoresis. An example of the application of PCR is the detection of pathogen DNA. The method's high specificity even enables microorganisms to be detected that are difficult or impossible to cultivate. Alternatively, the DNA can be further used and transferred, for example, into a bacterial genome. This genetic engineering method is used to produce therapeutic proteins like recombinant human insulin,